Praise the Lord. I thank God for this wonderful day and wonderful morning. God made it to be another day. I give glory to God for this day because He has been so faithful to our dear lives. You know, when God was creating man, He had to put all whatever is supposed to be inside him. But mainly, there was an element of worship. So I'm happy that God is really faithful. It is good every morning that we should worship God. Any time you get, it's good to worship God. Because my sister and my dear brother watching this video, God created you and me to worship Him. I know you are trying to pass through waves and many problems. Yes, it is so. But God is telling you this morning, worship me. I have a message God has given me today. As I was meditating and as I was reading my Bible and as I was praying, waiting upon Him in prayer in His presence, and God gave me this message. And the message says, I have not forsaken you. Let's pray. Father God, I say thank you. Thank you, Father God, for this time you have given me to share this message to someone listening now. Let this message touch his soul. Let this message touch someone's heart. So many people are weak. So many people are having no solution. A lot of confusion is in their minds. And they're up and down and they're saying, what can we do? What can I do? Should I kill myself? Should I take poison to live life? Because in their mindset, they think that it is the solution. But I give you glory, Lord, today. As I ask you, speak to our soul, speak to someone listening. In Jesus' name. Amen. Yeah, let us go to Isaiah 54. From verse 4. If you have your Bible, let us go to Isaiah chapter 54 from verse 4. But the Bible says, do not fear, for you will not be ashamed, neither be disgraced, for you will not be put to shame. Thank you, Jesus. And it continues to say, for you will forget the shame of your youth, and you will not remember the reproach of your widowhood anymore. The Lord of hosts is his name, and your Redeemer is the Holy One of Israel. He is called the God of the whole earth. For the Lord has called you, like a woman forsaken and grieved in the spirit, like a youthful wife when you were refused, says the Lord. Number 7. I love it. For a mere moment I have forsaken you, says the Lord. But with great mercies I will gather you, thank you, Jesus. With little wealth I hid my face from you for a moment. But with everlasting kindness, I will have mercy on you. Someone listening, someone watching this video, says the Lord, your Redeemer. For this is like the waters of Noah to me. For as I have sworn that the waters of Noah would no longer cover the earth, so have I sworn that I would that I would not be angry with you or rebuke you, for the mountains shall depart and the hills be removed, but my kindness shall not depart from you, nor shall my covenant of peace be removed. Thank you, Jesus. Let us go to verses 17. The Bible says, no weapon formed against you, listener, shall prosper, and every tongue which raises against you in judgment, you shall condemn. This is the inheritance of the servants of the Lord, and the righteous is from me, says the Lord. Thank you, Jesus, for this wonderful word. Praise the Lord. The Bible is saying that do not fear. What mountain do you see now? I know there are so many mountains ahead of you. I know you are saying you are forsaken. I know you are saying, what can I do? I know you are saying, how can I move forward? Look here. Sadrach, Meshach, Abednego were thrown in fire. But before they were put into fire, this fire was too much, as the Bible says. Amazingly, these people had faith in God, and they said that even though it doesn't help us, we shall not bow down to the idol. My dear sister, my dear brother, someone listening to this video and looking at this video, God is calling you, don't look at that idol, because the problem now is an idol to you. Don't look at that mountain you are looking at. Uplift your eyes now for a moment to Jesus, because he's going to surprise you with a miracle in Jesus' mighty name. Believe God, because this is the right time for him to manifest in your life. He's not a son of man to lie. I know your husband has lied to you. Your children have forsaken you. I know you are in a prison of problems. Yes, this is the right time. The message has come. Do not fear. God is telling you he has not forsaken you, my dear sister. God is calling your heart. He's saying, open up your heart this morning. Open up your heart and allow God to enter in your life. I know every problem is going to bow down to the knees of Jesus Christ. Do you know the bills you have are the bills of God? When you accept his will, he's willing to pay all the bills in Jesus' mighty name. Do you know that the sickness you have is not supposed to be in that body? Remember, the body you have, this is a temple of the Holy Spirit. It is not a temple of diseases. It's not a temple of infirmity. It's not a temple of problems. It is a temple where God sits. It is a temple where the Holy Spirit comes down and sits and dwells inside you. Allow God this wonderful day. I'm telling you, a miracle is coming to you. Allow God, allow the Holy Spirit to cover you, because there is in life nothing impossible to God. Look, the Bible says, do not fear, you will not be forsaken. You will not be ashamed. In most cases, you have been ashamed in front of people. You can never speak any word and people listen, because you are disguised and you are underlooked. I know you have not gone to school. I know you have rent. You have no money. I know you can never present yourself because of that problem. Yes. There is a man called Jesus who is going to represent you. He's going to open up a new album upon you. And people are going to be amazed. If you only believe today, believe, just believe. I know you have been believing. I know you have been praying. But only this chance is given. There is an invitation. I remember when I was given an invitation. And this invitation was given to me to go to attend a wedding party. When I reached to this party at Sheraton Hotel, I found the place was full and the number was limited, and they wouldn't allow me to enter because The number was full. I was so much disappointed. This is an invitation to you. This is not an invitation of disappointment. It is an invitation calling you, come. I know you are heavily laden and burdened. Come to Jesus. He will never forsake you. He will never desert you. He's telling us today, when you go, on verse 7, for a mere moment I have forsaken you. Do you know that sometimes you have been praying and as if God is not existing, he's not coming to help you? I've ever prayed, I went under my bed crying tears because I thought God is not listening. I thought God is under the bed. So I went under the bed crying in tears because I was tired of life. I was tired of problems. For a moment, Jesus Christ was quiet. Do you know that those problems you have been passing through have been tests of life? Tests you have been doing, and now it is time for a testimony? And this testimony is coming to you now. No man can be promoted unless he does his tests. The test of sickness, the test of all the problems that have been affecting you all around you. I know your husband ran away from your house and God went with another wife. Do you know that after a small time you're going to get a testimony? When you get time, read John chapter 9. There was a blind man. He suffered for a long time with blindness. He was born blind. And the question came to Jesus by the disciples. What did this man do? And the Bible says that Jesus said, he never sinned. The parents have never sinned. But this man has been like this and has remained like this for the glory of God to be manifested upon him. Do you know that the problems you've been passing through, they're going to promote you to another glory? Do you know that a testimony that is going to come out of the tests you have been passing through is going to be of help to many people? Do you know that it's going to be a solution? Many people are going to come crying tears because of the problems they are passing through. But because of the testimony you have, I'm telling you, it's going to redeem so many. Do you know that the testimony you have, you're going to have, this big testimony you are going to get, it's going to bring life and a solution to the coming generation? The people who will read the books you write, the people who will listen to the testimony you are giving? Just accept God. Accept him. He's telling you he has not forsaken you. Just put on a smile. The moment you put on an ugly face because of the problems, do you know that the devil smiles? The more you speak about your problems, you speak about your problems to the people, you speak about your problems, you cry tears, the devil dances. He goes and he puts on music, he starts dancing because he's seeing you are crying. But the more you worship the name of the Lord, the more you worship God, the more you put on the smile because you have the joy of salvation, the devil will never smile. Why? You know your salvation. You know your God because it's your salvation. Just believe God. Just trust God. For a moment he has forsaken you. Yes. Now he has come. He has come. Believe him. This is the word of God. For a mere moment, I've forsaken you. But with great mercies, I will gather you. Thank you, Jesus. With little wealth, I hid my face from you for a moment. But with everlasting kindness, I will have mercy on you, says the Lord. Oh, thank you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. I love you, God. Look here. Let us run to verses 10. For the mountains shall depart, and the hills be removed, but my kindness shall not depart from you. I know the mountains can depart. I know the money has gone. I know the beautiful wife has gone. I know this. I know you used to enjoy life and now you are in pain. Yes. God is telling you that they can, but My loving kindness will never depart away from you. I'm your Redeemer, says the Lord. He says this wonderful day, He is your Redeemer. No man can redeem you, woman of God. No man can redeem you, son of God. No man can redeem you out of that problem. Only God. Listen. The Bible says in verses 17, the same chapter. I love it. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. The devil has risen. He has a lot of weapons, we believe, and I know he has weapons he's using to fight you. But there is a weapon, and there are weapons, and these are weapons from the Lord he's using. Do you know that God is sending Angel Mike with his weapons to destroy all your enemies and to destroy all the problems you have been passing through? God is willing and is telling you that he's going to disarm your enemy. He's going to silence every communication, every spy network that has been on you spiritually. The devil has been spying you. Spying your plans. Whatever you plan, amazingly, it is being spied by the devil. But because of the weapon of the blood of Jesus Christ, you are covered in the blood of Jesus Christ. Wherever you pray, pray. And cover whatever plan you have in the blood of Jesus. Cover your family in the blood of Jesus. I'm telling you, God is willing to do great things in your life. No weapon formed against you. Oh, thank you, Jesus Christ. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Against you shall prosper. The devil can rise with his dust, but God sees it all. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. And every tongue which raises against you in judgment. Do you know that so many people have been speaking negative words upon you? People are speaking negative words. Even whatever they don't know, even those people, I'm sorry to say, even those people who don't know how to talk are talking. Because they have enough air time on their mouth and speaking against you. But listen to what God is telling you this day. That every tongue and every tongue which rises against you in judgment, you shall condemn. God is willing to fight for you. And every person who has been speaking negative words against you is going to bow down. He's going to come and kneel down and repent. I'm a man of God. I've seen it. God is not a son of man to lie. Yes, man can lie, but his word will never lie. This is the reason why he says he exalts his word above his name. This is the reason why he's keeping you alive to see your miracles, to reach your destiny. He can never forsake you. As I conclude, God is telling you, he has not forsaken you. He is with you. Stop crying. I'm seeing a woman of God who has been crying for a long time, but I'm seeing God has sent an angel. He's washing all the tears you have cried. A man of God, you have been crying tears because of the problems, because of the views. And I'm seeing God is washing all the tears. He's going to give you money to pay all the bills in Jesus' name. He's going to do it. In life, there is nothing impossible. But God, just believe. I've seen him working miracles, signs and wonders. Recently, I was praying for someone in the wheelchair. He has suffered for 15 years. The power of God came down, and this woman had to move out of the wheelchair. It is Jesus. Jesus loves you. Don't allow the devil to torment your mind. Just remain and just be with the mind of Christ. Love God because he loves you. Don't lose hope because God says he still has hope in you. So why are you losing hope? You think people who have forsaken you, who people who have deserted you, maybe these people have gone because they're not going to help you. God is going to bring someone to help you. Someone has your big blessing and is going to bring it to you. Do you know that the sickness you have, the doctors have failed? It is true. And they have a negative report over your life, and soon you are dying. Yes, the doctors have said so. But which report should we believe? Even we shall believe the report from the throne of God that you are healed in Jesus' name. Jesus loves you. Jesus trusts you. Jesus is there with you. In time of trials, he's saying he's with you. He has not forsaken you. He's going to surprise you. He's going to surprise you. We are going to pray. Believe him. He loves you. Let's pray. If you are sick, just touch where you are having a problem. If you are sick, just touch. Let this hand of God come upon you now in Jesus' name. If you have any bill to pay, if you are having questions too, and you need these questions to be answered, just put your hand in your chest. I'm telling you, the power of God is going to come upon you now in Jesus' name. Father God Almighty, I give you praise. I give you honor. I exalt your name, Lord, above every name. I've seen you healing. I've seen you changing. I've seen you reversing the unreversible. I've seen you, Lord, healing. My dear Father, I give you praise. I give you honor. Yesterday I was preaching, and one woman of God told me that, Muliika, you prayed for me. I had no house, and I was feeling, and I was having a lot of questions, saying, where will I go to? Because I don't have a house. But when you prayed in Jesus' name, now I have a house. My dear Father, recently in Hammerfest, my dear Father, you redeemed a lady who wanted to kill herself. Amazingly, she wanted to go and throw herself in the sea because she had a lot of stress and she was depressed. But amazingly, I give glory to God, this lady was totally delivered. My dear Father, look at this daughter of yours. Look at this servant of yours. Look at this woman having bills. Look at your daughter who is forsaken. The man had to run away. Look at your son, is stressed and he has nowhere to go. He's looking for a solution. The doctors have failed. My dear Father, remember your word is so powerful and your word is true. The Bible says that whosoever calls upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. My dear Father, I ask you, as I call upon you, Lord, have mercy upon your daughter. Have mercy upon that lady looking at this video, that woman looking at this video, listening to this message from your throne. Have mercy upon him in Jesus' name. She has cried for years. She has wetted all the pillow. She has been asking, what can I do? My dear Father God, this is the right time whereby, my dear Father, you are bringing a solution to your daughter. You are bringing a solution to that man. You are bringing a solution to that young man who has wanted to kill himself. Holy Spirit, I've seen you. I've seen you working with me. I've seen you changing situations. I've seen you delivering your people. My dear Father, I ask you this morning, remove all the tears, because the Bible says, tears are there in the night, but joy comes in the morning. My dear Father, I give you praise. Totally deliver someone. Totally deliver that one sick on the bed. Sick. Someone is walking in the wheelchair. God is reading you and is totally you. Someone is crying tears and is saying, I think because I'm forsaken, that is the end of life. God is telling you, he has not forsaken you. Believe him. Trust him because he loves you. He loves you. You just believe him this wonderful day. May God bless you so much. May God keep you. Always love him because he loves you. This is the only person who gave his own life for you. No one can give his life for others unless Jesus. Jesus is the only person who was crucified. A lot of blood came out of him because of you. 39 stripes were put on his body for you to be healed. I give you glory, God, because you are healing her. You are redeeming him. You are changing him. In Jesus' name. May God bless you so much. May God increase you. May God bless you. So now hear a testimony that God made it. Stay.